Well, there's a momentary pause, and then people started offering observations. Well, the leader I'm thinking about had vision, someone said, so I wrote vision on the flip chart. Somebody else said, the person I'm thinking about had great charisma, and so I would write down charisma. And with that opening, the characteristics of leadership started to flow. And it was going very well. From my estimation, it was going very well. About 10 minutes into this activity, I looked down, and the CEO, who had been up to that particular point participating actively himself, and you all know how important that is. If the top man, the top woman in the organization is participating and giving it their vote of confidence, others follow along. That's the whole concept of leadership and followership. And this CEO was doing a wonderful job, in my estimation, of setting the tone for being open to learning. But as I looked down at him, I saw him do something, no exaggeration whatsoever. I saw him, in the course of this activity, lay his pen on a pad of paper and then scoot himself away from the table. And when he had cleared the table, he crossed his arms and he reared back and he said these words audibly. Yeah, I do all those things. And immediately, 75% of the eyes went down. 75% of the people in that room immediately chose to look at the table at the same moment. Now, most of the people in the room would not have seen that because of where they were sitting, but because of where I was sitting and could see the whole panorama, I saw 75% of the eyes go down. As if to say, unspoken, but as if to say, I can't look at my friend, I can't look at my neighbor, they might find me out, I might get tickled and laugh, so I might get in trouble. Now, I've been doing this for a lot of years, and I've done it many, many times. I can tell when a program's going well, and I can tell when a program, quite frankly, is on the rocks. This one had the potential to be on the rocks. Why? Because all of a sudden, something that was moving along so nicely because of one leader's act, or more specifically, one leader's comment, had a fundamental change on the feeling in the room. Well, even though we'd only been going for a relatively short period of time, I knew I had to do something to change the flow. Remember, I had another 2.5 hours or so to go. And so I suggested, guys, I tell you what, let's take a quick stretch break. I have a need to get a couple things together, and if you'll help me out, I'd appreciate it. Well, you never have to tell people twice to take a break. Everybody stood up, started moving around, started moving toward the back of the room. Everybody, that is, except one person, and I noticed him immediately. He was someone that was in the middle aisleway, a relatively young guy. He had his hands in his pocket, and he kind of turned sideways, profile to me at the front of the room, to his colleagues in the back of the room. And he really wasn't engaged in any conversation at all. It seemed like he was talking to himself. And in the course of this conversation with himself, it looked like he was even doing battle, arguing with himself. And I became intrigued. I am an observer. I think the best leaders are observers of what's going on around them, especially as it relates to the people around them. And quite frankly, I wanted to know what was going on. And so I walked up to him. Now, I didn't get up in his space. I didn't walk up to him and go, I can tell you're thinking about something. He didn't know me. He wouldn't probably have responded very well to that. Instead, I just walked up and got in close proximity and tried to mimic his behavior. I put my hands in my pocket and I looked down as he was looking down. I don't know why, but psychologically it apparently worked because the young man walked by me. Now I want to stress, he never came to a complete stop. He didn't have to. He delivered his message and then was on his way. He walked up to me, just those 3 or 4 or 5 feet, he walked to me and leaned in as he was passing, and he said these actual words. I hope the old man is getting some of this. And with that, his message delivered, he was gone. I want you to think about those words for a moment. I hope the old man is getting some of this. Now, whether or not it was appropriate to call his boss the old man, let's just sort of forgive that for a moment. What he was really saying was this. the old man, the person in charge, the authority, the leader, says he does all those things, but I, the follower, am cognizant, am aware that he doesn't. I hope he can get some of these things. Why do we come to conferences? Why do we participate in educational opportunities like these breakout sessions? Well, for one, it's to be with colleagues, but today you're not with colleagues. Maybe you're in a conference room someplace, but you're not with colleagues outside of the realm of your own business. Other reasons are, well, I like to be entertained. Well, I'm not the best joke teller that's ever came down the pike. But some of you come to conferences because you want to have your parameters stretched. You want to know about what the possibilities are. That's my job, is to get you, like the old man, to think about and to consider leadership beyond where they think they are, and instead to consider leadership where their followers want them to be.